Coming up on UCF Nightly News, we have more on the AE Pi allegations.
Plus, we'll show you the new technology UCF nursing students are using to learn about the transgender community.
And spring break is upon us. We'll take you to the beach where officials are cracking down on open containers.
And we have breaking news in sports. Orlando City's clash against the New England Revolution is postponed. We'll tell you the new date.
Nightly News starts now. Good afternoon and welcome to Nightly News. I'm Eric Scott.
And I'm Bridget Snedeker. Today is Friday, March 10th, 2017. Alpha Epsilon Pi is suspended from campus after an allegation UCF police says deals with a rifle. We first brought this to you as breaking news. Nightly News talked to a former international president who called it a rogue incident. The University of Central Florida suspended Alpha Epsilon Pi over hazing allegations. An email sent to the police accuses the pledge master of holding a rifle barrel to a pledge's head.
This was a brother who did this without the knowledge of other members of the fraternity and leadership of the fraternity, the chapter.
The chapter hasn't been active on social media and didn't answer to Nightly News' request for comment.
And they know that kind of behavior is clearly antithetical to our values and beliefs. It's also illegal. More likely to be illegal.
UCF senior Adam Moore was part of a fraternity expelled by UCF and knows what that suspension process is like.
I think that the current suspension shows, you know, what UCF does. I think they're doing somewhat of the same manner and kind of throwing them into suspension before they know anything and then seeing what happens and then delegating the consequence.
He and his brothers decided to make their own organization independent of UCF, the Gazzoni family, but says he thinks the process UCF operates under is incorrect.
I think, you know, throwing someone into interim suspension before you really understand the facts is kind of unjust because anyone could write a letter about a fraternity saying, hey, I was a pledge, I got hazed.
The Office of Fraternity and Sorority Life would not comment on the allegations. A date for the conduct hearing has not been set. Alpha Epsilon Pi is the third Greek organization to be suspended just this semester.
Spring break is almost here for UCF, and SGA is helping students get to and from the airport via Night Flight. Night Flight is a shuttle service that brings students and their luggage to and from Orlando International Airport to catch their spring break flights. The shuttle will leave UCF multiple times today through Sunday and will make trips from MCO for UCF starting Friday, March 17th, through Sunday, March 19th. Students must sign up, receive a confirmation, and show their UCF ID to board the shuttle. The shuttle stop is located at the Lynx UCF bus stop between Garage A and I. Students can sign up for rides on SGA's website up until the time the shuttle leaves.
Study Abroad UCF is offering new trips this year, and one of them allows students to visit Cuba for the first time during spring break. Nightly News reporter Dianelis Fuentes tells us how one student is using this program to reconnect with his roots.
I want to kind of explore the culture of that side of my family and get to know a little bit more about that.
Corbin Gonzalez is excited to visit his father's country for the first time. He's among the first UCF students going to Cuba during this spring break.
I think I'm just looking forward to seeing Cuba and getting a taste for the culture and exploring some of those aspects that it's kind of known for these days is still being kind of stuck in the past a little bit, so I think that'll be interesting.
Casey Tart, who's one of the professors leading the program, says the trip focuses on cultural activities so students from all majors can participate.
So we have students who are medical students, students who are studying economy, art, and so that was, you know, our main focus was to have it be open to everyone.
Gonzalez is glad UCF is offering this program, giving him the opportunity to visit Cuba as something more than a tourist.
Students will be staying with actual Cuban people in their homes while we're going, so I think it'll be a more realistic feel than if I were to just go travel on my own.
After their trip, students will meet twice a week to talk about their experience and how to apply it to their professional life. In Orlando, Dianelis Fuentes, UCF Nightly News.
The program not only includes visits through Havana, like Ernest Hemingway's estates, but students can also explore Cuba's hot springs in the province of Pinar del Río.
With many students hitting the beach this spring break, it's important to remember to remain safe. Velusa.org says when visiting the beach, always swim in front of a lifeguard. Ask lifeguards about the rip current risk before getting in the water. For those driving on the beach, the speed limit is 10 miles per hour. Violators will be fined, and alcohol in glass containers are not allowed on the beach.
Safe Night Week is giving students a reality check on driving under the influence.
Are we now ready to begin our trial?
In the center to role play a court trial with witnesses, judges, and lawyers. Asima Chirardi says this is a mock trial that gives students a reality check of what you could face driving under the influence.
Our first witness, Jake Miller, at about 50 miles
this type of example is good to show people that, you know, there are consequences, there is sympathy, there is emotion, there's a lot of people involved, and we found that this is a good setting and environment to educate people.
Chidori also wants this experience to help students make safer decisions. For more information on the UCF mock trial team, you can visit trialteamucf.com.
Swerving over to spring break, UCF's break starts today, and some students are already hitting the roads. But the UCF Police Department asks students who are traveling over the next week to use precaution. They recommend locking your doors and windows and taking all valuables with you. Make sure your tires are fully inflated and have a full tank of gas before getting on the road. According to UCF Police Officer Peter Stevens, it is not a smart idea to post on social media that you're leaving town.
With spring break coming up, we really want students to think about their safety. Yes, it is a good time to be out there and wandering around and doing stuff, but having a charged cell phone, very, very important. Knowing where you're going and letting somebody know where you're going. Have a plan.
With students being gone for spring break, the UCF Police Department asks for your eyes and ears if you are staying on campus. If you see anything suspicious, please report it.
So Florida definitely seems to be warming up for spring break.
Yeah, and especially today, we saw warmer temperatures. Corny, what's it like outside right now?
Yeah, well, you guys are definitely right. It is warm outside, and what a great way to start off spring break. So right now, the weather is warm. Like I said, temperature is hitting 85 with humidity at 64%, which is down from this morning. If you walked out, probably took you a couple minutes to get that dew off your windshield. The wind is coming from the west at 5 to 10 miles per hour. And as for rain, we're looking nice and dry at a 0% chance.
Thank you so much, Courtney. Coming up after the break, we'll show you what's being done to clean up our Florida beaches.
Plus, we'll tell you how to avoid falling prey to email scams.
Florida beaches are a known hotspot for spring breakers all over the U.S. Nightly News reporter Cami Hernandez tells us how beach officials are preparing.
Okay, to pop a cold brew here, but not here. To control the mess from spring breakers on the beach, Volusia County Beach Captain Tammy Maris and her team are putting the lid on open containers.
We do a lot of times in lieu of an arrest or a fine for drinking on the beach, we ask them to pick up a bunch of trash instead.
Maris says drinking on the beach is against county ordinance. If you're caught with booze and you're over 21, you could face a $50 fine with possible arrest. One spring breaker says throwing away trash is a better option than landing behind the bars.
I mean, ideally, we all just pick up our trash and recycle a bit. I mean, it's probably a little bit tougher if everyone has, if there's just a cleanup crew afterwards picking up everything. I mean, if everyone just picks up their trash and tries to recycle, I'm sure it'd be a lot better.
With spring break comes more trash. Beach officials ask to throw away your trash on your way out to keep the environment clean.
With the increase of crowds, Daytona Beach officials continue to control alcohol violations and littering problems this time of year. Maris says the problem simply moved from one location in Florida to another.
We've seen a big increase in spring break crowds last year due to the ban of alcohol in Panama City.
And some students understand the importance to keep the community playground clean.
For all of us here, like, we live around lakes and everything, and we all know how important clean water is for, you know, the animals that live in the water and even just the people that are on the beach and everything.
Now Maris and her team are ready for the wave of students to crash in.
We automatically have more staffing this time of year, more boots on the ground, so to speak, on the beach.
Reporting in Daytona Beach, Cami Hernandez, UCF Nightly News.
Daytona Beach officials reported 25 alcoholic violations already this week, 15 more than the average violations reported.
UCF nursing students are receiving training for what they say will make transgender students more comfortable at the doctors, all with the help of some new technology. The UCF College of Nursing is one of the few colleges to use a new kind of stimulation dummy. The technology uses a mannequin by the name of Taylor. Taylor is a lifelike transgender patient who speaks and presents medical symptoms so nursing students can get hands-on experience. Associate Professor Desiree Diaz says their main goal is to make all patients feel equal and welcomed at doctor's visits.
Our goal is not to get into the specifics of why they chose to be transgender and make those changes. Our goal is to treat them as humans. The American Nurses Association's social policy statement is treating a patient where they're at in time.
The College of Nursing is also a multicultural lab, so students can interact with mannequin patients who have different gender identities as well as different cultures.
Some student inboxes are being flooded with spam email. The email claimed to be from university official. They prompt students to reset their passwords because they have expired. Although the emails come from an Outlook account, they are not official UCF addresses. Dr. Ted Reynolds teaches a class about cybersecurity and says students need to know what to look out for.
And make sure it's a legitimate UCF email address. And then just, you know, wait a little while. Don't immediately respond, because UCF's really good when some of this stuff comes up. Within, you know, a few hours, tech support or whoever will send out an email.
Reynolds suggests students change all their passwords often. He also mentions to be part of what you post on social media.
Coming up after the break, Courtney Giacobazzi tells us what the weather looks like during spring break.
Plus, we'll tell you how one student is hoping to put a stop to food waste.
a new study shows the issue of food waste in America and how more of it is ending up in the trash. Nightly News reporter Leah Fernandez tells us how a UCF researcher is taking action to combat everything being thrown away.
A lot of people in the United States are wasting about 20 pounds of food per month.
Senior Catherine Nina is a UCF researcher hoping to work towards putting a stop to food waste.
If everyone is reducing their food waste, that takes a huge drastic toll down, right? So that's one person, that's 200 pounds per year. A community, that's hundreds of thousands or even millions of pounds.
A new study by the University of Edinburgh says consumer waste is a factor of 2.1 billion tons of harvested crops lost. Nina suggests smarter shopping tactics to reduce the food waste.
So first in, first out, the items that you purchase first at the grocery should be going towards the front. So the stuff that's older is at the front of your fridge. So you use that first before you use the stuff that you buy later.
Associate Vice President for Research Debbie Reinhart works closely with Nina and sees the help the research can bring.
By focusing on food waste, we feel that we can help in a small way to reach the amount of food that we're going to need in the future and today.
Dr. Reinhart says from the grocery store to our plates, about 30 to 40% of food is wasted in America.
It's a huge investment that can be reduced.
Nina and Reinhart are looking to expand their research beyond campus.
We're planning a huge event, hopefully with student government, to really show awareness about food waste. And we want to continue growing this to not only maybe in the UCF area, but partner with other universities and kind of expand it so food waste is at the forefront.
The study also mentions efforts like Nina's to reduce billions of tons lost can help prevent environmental harm. Reporting in Orlando, Leah Fernandez, UCF Nightly News.
And moving forward, Nina's research is seeing what we can do as a student initiative to reduce food waste. She's partnering with others on campus to take a bigger step in the right direction.
Like most UCF students, I'm certainly excited for the start of spring break. Bridget, do you have any exciting plans?
Yeah, so I'm mostly excited to be on the South Florida beach.
Yeah, I certainly want to take advantage of that. Courtney, what can we expect the weather to look like during the break?
Well, guys, we can expect the weather to look just as any tourist making their way here would expect Florida to look like for spring break. Warm and sunny and dry. Right now, we'll take a look at what the temperatures are looking like across the state. Tallahassee at 80, Orlando at 85, Miami at 79. And we're going to stay warm as we're getting this westerly breeze coming across the state and instead of an easterly flow. So that is keeping the temperatures extremely warm and allowing them to rise quickly. And speaking of temperatures rising quickly, I'm going to show you a little chart that I made. Looking at some of the average temperatures for this time of year, today's average is 77 degrees. Now we're here at 85 degrees today, which is almost 10 degrees warmer than what we're supposed to be according to the National Weather Service. But if there's any good news when it comes to being above average, at least we're not what it was in 1925 when we hit 93 degrees. But away from the heat, we'll take a look at tonight's lows. What are we going to look like for tonight for our first Friday of spring break? Well, nice and cool, actually. We are going to have 49 degrees over in Tallahassee, Jacksonville 55, Orlando 61. So we're looking at about a 20 degree difference between this afternoon and this evening. So if you're heading out, 61 can feel a little chilly with the wind chill, so make sure and bring a jacket. Now, we'll head on over to rain because that definitely factors in your spring break plans. Well, what are we looking like today? Nice and dry across most of the state. Tallahassee, a couple of showers, just a little bit of a pressure system, low pressure system above Tallahassee that's giving it a little bit of rain. But for the most part, looking nice and dry. So a great start to our spring break as we make our way into the later afternoon and evening for our first day. Now, is it going to stay this way? Well, this is where we're going to take a look into our five-day forecast. Take a look at the temperatures and those rain chances for you here. Now into the weekend, staying warm, 78 degrees. We're going to dip down to the low 60s, but don't forget Sunday is daylight savings time. So 2 a.m., make sure and set those clocks forward. We're going to lose an hour of sleep, unfortunately, and we're even going to get some rain in the beginning of the week along with that jump forward. So not a great start to the beginning of the week, but it's going to get cool after that and stay nice and sunny and beautiful so you can enjoy your midweek of spring break. Back to you guys.
Thank you so much, Courtney. Hopefully we can get out of the rain. Coming up after the break, Orlando City's match against the New England Revolution is postponed. We'll tell you the next time you can find the Lions on the field.
Plus, UCF baseball faced off against one of their in-state rivals.
Get out of the rain.
Good afternoon, Knights. I'm Samantha McCollum with your sports update for the week. Orlando City's weekend clash against the New England Revolution is now rescheduled for September 4th. The Lions planned on visiting the Revs this weekend in an Eastern Conference clash. The match was postponed due to extreme cold projected to hit the Northeast tomorrow. Orlando City is coming off of a massive 1-0 win over 2015 expansion rival New York City FC on opening day. And newly acquired defender Donny Toya says he's impressed with the defensive display so far.
Like, I played pretty well defensively, so I think as a team we were solid all around. I think if we keep the ball a little bit more instead of hitting direct balls too much, but I think all around we were great.
The next match will take place inside Orlando City Stadium on March 18th against Philadelphia Union. The match is rescheduled to kick off at 7:30 p.m. The UCF baseball team lost 5-0 to number 2 Florida State at the UCF Baseball Complex Wednesday. The best chance for the black and gold to get on the board came in the 8th inning. First baseman Austin Griffith drew a leadoff walk, and third baseman Matthew Micah added a single up in the middle. With one out, Eli Putnam placed a bunt down the third baseline and beat out the third for an infield hit. Unfortunately, with the bases loaded, Luke Humling smacked a line drive right at the third baseman, who then forced a double play. Next up, the Knights will host Central Michigan for a three-game series beginning tonight. The UCF men's basketball team begins their run to the top of the American Athletic Conference today at 2 p.m. Coach Donnie Dawkins led the Knights to a 20-win regular season. AAC Defensive Player of the Year Taco Fall and B.J. Taylor continue to play a pivotal role in Coach Dawkins' first season. The Knights can clinch a spot in the NCAA March Madness Tournament if they win the AAC Conference Tournament. First, the Knights will battle the Memphis Tigers in the quarterfinal matchup on ESPN2. With a win, the Knights will move on to the AAC semifinal at 3 p.m. on Saturday. That's all the time I have for sports today. I'm Samantha McCollum. Back to you guys at the desk.
Yeah, before we start talking about that UCF men's basketball matchup and that critical AAC game, Orlando City, they opened up their stadium last weekend. Bridget, it was a beautiful scene. I had the opportunity to be there, and obviously they finished off with style with getting a 1-0 win.
It looked beautiful. I think the new stadium is exactly what we need, you know, to make our team really, really shine.
And you heard it from the Lions players. They were excited to see the wall there, 25,000 in their seats, excited to be there for one of the most popular MLS teams in MLS. And listen, we talk about this UCF basketball game. They'll have an opportunity to move on into the AAC semifinal tonight if they're able to beat Memphis. And, hey, maybe a chance to get into the NCAA March Madness tournament here.
I hope so, because I know that our basketball team has been on a good streak so far. And if you don't follow us and you want the latest news, make sure to follow UCF Nightly News on our Twitter and our Facebook page. We'll always post things there. Remember, you can always keep up live with us on our website, nightlynews.ucf.edu.
And don't forget, in just moments away from ESPN2's game with UCF taking on Memphis at 2 o'clock, that's all the time we have for today. Have a wonderful day.